Hello everyone, now I'm going to introduce you a resistance meter, or people call it ohm meter. This ohm meter is produced by Uni-T China. The model is UT620B. Now let's open this package. This is a new machine. I just want to demo it to all of you. All right. We can see clearly in this package, this is the machine itself, the main body. Here are some cables, and this one is a menu. Alright, let's put the menu aside and bring out this machine. Let's see the machine first. This is how it looks like from front and from side. Here's a handle. We can use our hand to hold it during our on-site measurements. And on the top, there are some ports for connection of the cables. And of course, here's another. This one is a hanger. We can hold on it. And this side, we can see here, this is the charging port. And bottom, there's nothing at the bottom. From behind, here is a handle. Okay, there is a handle, the machine can stand on the table using the stand. Yeah, this one is a stand from behind. And this one also can keep into the place, kept inside. If we don't want to use the stand, if we want to use, we just click here, the handle's coming out. Yes, the handle's coming out. All right. As you can see, there is many buttons and also a wheel in the middle. We can twist this wheel to the desired ohm range, the resistance range. Let's turn it on and have a look what it look like. This is off, and here are the resistance range from 6000 ohm until 60 milliohm. First we turn on this machine. Okay, the machine is on and it is out too. And here is the battery, the power indicator, and out too. And here is the unit, ohm. And we didn't put on the cable yet. This is the
now
place
to trying to operate this machine. I have turned this machine on by this turn this button from off to any of this point. These are the measuring ranges of the ohm meter from 6000 ohm to 60 milliohm. Now we turn it to the largest resistance, 6000 ohm, and on the screen we didn't see any readings because we didn't connect it to any cables. And come together with the machine, there's two cables. This one is the full wire tester cable, and this one is a standard Kelvin clips. Now we just use this Kelvin clip to do the test. On the top of the machine, there are some of the ports to connect the cable. Now we have this Kelvin clip. The Kelvin clip, the red one will connect it to T plus, and the black cable we will connect it to T minus. red 2T plus, black 2T minus. Put it back. And we have this clamp, these clips. We can open it. Let's try to find something for the testing. Now we have a resistor. According to this card, resistor card, we read 3301 of this resistor is 3301 ohm, okay? And now we're trying to test this resistor. I take off this cable. One side and clamp another side. Alright, and we click the machine test. It is the 0.3385. It is still going lower. We need to wait until the machine becomes stable. Okay, so the data now is 0.3376 kilo ohm. Kilo ohm, that is equal to 337.5 ohm, okay, 337.4 ohm. Just now as our reading, it is 330 ohm, and the tolerance is plus minus 10%, and the data is quite accurate comparing with risk reading. So we can see that this machine is working well. Let's try this cable. It's just a simple cable. Just now we used the component, we got the reading 0.3375. Now we're trying the new one. This is just simply a cable, so the resistance must be low, lower than what we tested just now. So we try again. All right. We start. You see, the resistance is just 0.0001 kilo ohm. That is 0.1 ohm, very low. So basically, the machine is very sensitive and give the, I think, is very accurate result. As what we used just now, the components is according to the to its specification. This is the specification for the resistor we used just now. Okay, let's hold this one and we're trying to verify it. And we have another thing we can use for the testing.